scenario that said tax forum leaders need to check their biases at the door. And this actually made me laugh. First, the forum sets up to be a one-sided affair. Well, I guess if you say that all of us, the people that elect our government officials, are one side and they're the other, I suppose you could say that. But as far as the Patriots are concerned, we try to provide an unbiased voice. We're a nonpartisan group. And what we're trying to do is facilitate discussion and educate and inform you guys, the public. So I don't really think that we're here to try and, you know, purport that our views on things are the views that you should have. The view we have is that elected officials work for the people, so we give the people a voice. The second thing is, mentions that our tax assessor, Brian Huber, pulled out. That's correct. We tried to schedule a meeting for his availability, and later when he withdrew, I was sorry to see that. I hoped that he would come tonight. He isn't here, is he? Brian, are you here? Okay, well, it was my hope that he would come and respond to questions. I think that would have been a good thing. And the third problem here in this article is that Brookhart and other Patriots, it says Brookhart leaves little doubt that the information dispensed, including information from a lawyer handpicked by the Patriots, will support the viewpoints of the host. You know, that's just flat out wrong. And we work very hard to try and hear all opinions. When the assessor put in an article in the paper that said that he wanted to come in people's homes, you know, I guess I do have a bias. No, I don't want him to come in my home. And most of the people I've spoken to don't like that either. So, you know, we all have biases. I'm very upfront about them. The Central Oregon Patriots. We're the Central Oregon Patriots, okay? We believe in the Constitution. We believe in people's rights and that sort of thing. We also believe in the First Amendment, which means you can say your mind. That's why we're going to have mics around later. So with that, let me just give you a couple quick facts, and then we'll get on with the show. I wanted to mention you all got a packet. In the packet was the information that's been going on in the newspapers and things like that recently. So you can read it for yourself. On the front page is a survey. We put the survey together just to get a sense of where people are at on this whole topic, and tried to make it as unbiased as we could, but as pointed as we could, so that we could actually collect information. There's coffee and drinks and things like that in the back. Feel free. We try to do this informally, so you can get up. If you want a cup of coffee, go get one. And we'll take a light stretching break here about halfway. There are some raffle tickets over there, which is how we fund these sorts of events. They're unbelievably expensive by the time you run ads and all that sort of thing. That's how we support it, with funds from you. We try and use a property owner can and can't do. And I would have to say also, just handed to me by the sheriff when he came in the door, there is a new position paper out from the assessor, and it is kind of backpedaling, I would say, on some of the things that we've been hearing. And maybe the sheriff will talk about this a little bit more when he gets up to talk. But it's more respectful of the landowners and the homeowners. So it's a very encouraging thing to see. With that, I'm done. And I will invite our first speaker up, Casey Kaiser from the chamber.